So you are new to Fusion 360 and have just learned the basics of how to use closed contours to create extruded solids or cuts. So where do you go from here? Here are a few important lessons that you need to learn in order to truly master the extrude command. Lesson 1. You don't have to start extruding from the sketch plane. The middle section of this model was extruded from the primary top plane. Suppose that the design intent has changed and you need the midsection to be slightly above the top plane. Instead of starting over and creating a sketch on an offset plane, you can go into the existing extrude by right-clicking and going to Edit Feature. Go to the Start option and choose Offset Plane. Upon selecting that, the offset dimension field appears. Enter the desired offset distance from the top plane. If I enter a value of 10mm and confirm, the extrude is now 10mm above the top plane. Take note that the extrude thickness is preserved. Lesson 2. You can control extrudes with respect to existing surfaces or bodies. This is an important aspect of parametric design. The most direct way of controlling the extent of an extrude is to enter a distance. However, that might not be ideal in all situations, especially when the geometry surrounding the extrude in question is subjected to change. As much as possible, we should let the design intent drive the extrude extent. The design intent is for the cylinder to be a certain distance from the top face of this C-shaped frame. I can certainly do a simple calculation and enter the required distance. The disadvantage of doing this is that when the external frame changes, the extrude does not change accordingly. In order for the cylinder to react to a changing external frame, the extrude extent has to be controlled with respect to the top face. To do that for extent, we need to choose two objects. Select the top face of the frame and impose an offset distance. Once we confirm and change the frame, the cylinder regenerates accordingly and maintains that same offset distance. The same effect can be achieved for an extrude in two directions. Here we have a sketch in the middle of the same frame. In the extrude command for direction, choose two sides. Now we have an extrude that can be controlled in either direction of the sketch plane. As with the previous example, go to extent and choose two objects for side 1. Select the top face of the frame and enter an offset distance. Do the same for side 2. When the frame changes, the cylinder adjusts accordingly. Let's try the same concept for an extruded cut. In this example, I need to maintain a certain material thickness to the bottom face. For extent, choose two objects, select the bottom face, and enter the offset distance. You might need to enter a negative sign in front to flip the offset direction. When the size of the cuboid changes, the material thickness is maintained. Lesson 3. The extrude command can be used to create non-planar features. In order to begin the extrude command, the starting profile has to be planar. With this condition, there is a misconception that the extrude command can only produce planar features. That is not true. The extrude command can actually leverage on existing non-planar faces to produce non-planar features. In this example, we have a sketch in front of a cylinder. Select the sketch profile to start an extrude. For the start condition, select From Object and select the cylindrical surface. As you drag out the extrude and observe from the top, you can see that the extruded surface follows the curvature of the cylindrical surface. Looking normal to the sketch, the extrude profile follows the sketch lines exactly. This is a result of the sketch lines being projected onto the cylindrical surface in a direction that is normal to the sketch plane. A cut can also be done in the same way. The same workflow can be performed on more complex surfaces. Extrudes can start from a planar face and end on a non-planar face. Here, we need this cylinder to terminate against this body with two adjacent faces. For extend, select two objects and select this face. At this point, you can see that the extrude only terminates up to this straight face. However, we need the extrude to fill up this gap as well. This is where we need to select the chain faces option. With that, the extrude fully extends up to both surfaces. Another way of doing this is to select the body instead. Remove the existing selections, go to the bodies folder and select the body. Fusion would recognize that you want to extrude up to the body as a whole. In this case, you are presented with a minimum solution and a maximum solution. The minimum solution would be appropriate in this case. Lesson 4. The extrude command has the ability to create separate bodies that do not merge into one another. This is an important precursor to performing Boolean operations in Fusion 360, where you can manipulate how bodies interact with each other to create complex shapes. I have a circular sketch here above a cuboid. Let's start an extrude with the sketch. Let's drag this extrude beyond the top face of the cuboid. Go to Operation, select New Body, and Confirm. If you check the Bodies folder, there are two separate bodies, the cuboid and the cylinder. These are not merged into one another. I can use this cylinder as a cutting tool to produce a cut in the cuboid. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the cuboid as the target body and select the cylinder as the cutting tool. For operation, select Cut. We have multiple bodies here, and we need to perform a selective cut through some of the bodies. In this case, you will be presented with a list of objects to cut. Check the body or bodies that you need to cut. Besides these four major lessons, the following are a few interesting aspects of the extrude command that might be of interest to you. In this extrude scenario, when we drag the arrow beyond the top face of the cuboid, Fusion guesses that we are trying to do a cut. If we go to Operation and select the Intersect option, Fusion actually cuts on the outside of the circle. A way to visualize this is to imagine the overlapping volume between the cylinder and the existing cuboid. We don't have to draw complete sketches all the time. For example, if we draw a line on this face that snaps to the two opposite edges, Fusion recognizes this as a legitimate contour that can be selected for extrusion. We can use faces of existing bodies to begin an extrude. We have a cuboid above a cylinder here. You can select the top face of the cylinder to begin an extrude. For start, select from object and select the top face of the cuboid. With that, we can leverage on the existing cylindrical face to create an extrude on another surface. Let's take a look at the final example where we will make use of all that we have learned so far. This solid body was created by revolving this sketch. The inside face is an arc, while the outside face is composed of two adjacent planar faces at an angle to each other. I have prepared a sketch of a slot on the front plane. The end result we want to achieve is a separate smaller body that sits in a recess. We select the slot profile to begin the extrude. Let's drag out the extrude slightly. For the start condition, select from object and select the inside face. Let's ignore the fact that this is a cut for the moment. Looking at the finished model, we need this to be offset from the inside face. So let's enter an offset distance. If the offset direction is wrong, put a negative sign in front. We need the outside face of the extrude actually follow these angular faces. For extend, select two objects and select one of the faces. Select the chain faces option. At the moment, the extrude is flushed with the two faces. We need an offset here, so enter an offset distance. Again, we need to add a negative sign to flip the offset direction. We have fully defined the starting and extend conditions of the extrude. Go to operation and change it to new body. Confirm and check the bodies folder. We now have two bodies. To create a recess, go to Modify, Combine. Select the main body as the target body, and select the smaller body as the tool. For operation, select Cut. After the operation, we need to retain the smaller body, so check on the Keep Tools option.